Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope it's doing well and staying safe. Anyway guys, so we're back on another Blu-ray haul for you guys. My dad has a lot to show you, well, me, but and I have some movies as well over the past week or so. So I'm going to show you his, and we also have one. Get out of here now.
I just wanted to let everybody know that I'm here.
Get out of here. Anyway, so, and plus we have a one to show you from Amazon, which we have a story about that, guys. So I will tell you about that at the end of the video, okay? So let's go ahead and show you what he got, and I'll show you mine, all right? Okay, so the first one up is a Kino title, which I like Kino to. They're putting subcovers on their movies, which is pretty awesome. So the first one up is Runaway Train. Now we have this like three times now. We have this one, the Arrow edition, and the Twilight Time film one. But I like the cover of this one. He's been telling me this movie's really good. So this is from 1985. Of course, you got John Voight, Eric Roberts, and Rebecca De Mornay in here as well, guys. But this one actually looks really cool. I really want to watch this one. I like John Voight, so... and Eric Roberts, so I like the supple on this one, guys.
Yeah,
so.
And I think I have one of them open.
Yeah,
I think it's the UK. I don't think I didn't open, or did I open the
no,
the I Arrow didn't open the Twilight movie.
No, nope, the Arrow you have open. So yeah. There's that, guys.
Yeah, and awesome. I wonder if is that a scan on that one? No, not they're, that.
The Arrow one.
I think
they usually are. But these Kinos are usually a 2K scan, which they usually are. So, yeah. Anyway, next up, we actually watched this one the other night, and I thought this one was actually pretty fun. And that is Bait, guys. This is a 3D version, but we didn't watch the 3D version of this one. But this has the guy from Nip/Tuck. I think his name is Xavier. And also the guy from the Twilight movies. So, I don't remember his name, but...
Yeah, and something she didn't mention real quick is we have the, what do you call it, it's like a four-pack. Is it the four-pack?
I was going to get to that. It's in there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was going to do that last.
I'm sorry. Yes. I didn't know if you were going to mention that or not.
We got a story, guys. But this is actually pretty fun. I actually kind of enjoyed this one. So, but if you haven't seen it, just check it out, guys. There's Bait 3D. Who doesn't love a good shark movie, right? All right, next one up, I actually kind of told him to get this one because we can never find it at Best Buy or anywhere. So we ended up getting from Amazon. So excited to send another Shudder title, which we got like four or five Shudder movies in our collection, which is really awesome. Next one up is Psycho Goreman. This one actually looks really cool, guys. But it says he will bathe in your blood. A heartwarming and heart-ripping family classic. So really like the symbol on that one, guys. But yeah, we'll read about it here. But awesome. Sweet. I really want to watch that one. It looks really good. All right, next one up, guys, is a movie with Charlton Heston in it. And Walter Pidgeon, that's 2 Minute Warning. This is from Shout Factory, which is really cool. From 1976. I should watch this one. This one actually looks really cool. All right, next one up, guys, he finally bought this third season on Blu-ray. He has the first two seasons, and that is Killing Eve. Like I said, it's the third season, which kind of sucks. The first one didn't have a slipcover on it, which I'm not sure if it ever did, but the second and the third season do have one. So, I really like the slipcover. This one's all embossed right here, guys. But, yeah, awesome.
Yeah, I was looking forward to the fourth season. Yeah. And, of course, you know, it's been postponed to the, COVID. So, I'm not sure if they're even going to get the fourth season in this year, but. Yeah, I said it before to you. That's very addicting.
I haven't seen it, but...
No, I don't know if that's your cup of tea, so to speak, but I, you know, Karen and I like it.
Yep. So this Killing Eve Season 3. This came on AMC, guys, and BBC as well. Or BBC America. Okay. Next up, which you saw in my shopping video, he ended up picking up the slipbook of this one, but he always wanted to get the standard slipcover edition so he could watch it. Found it at Target for $24.99 versus Best Buy's $30, and that is the 2014 Godzilla 4K edition. So you know the new one comes out this Friday, guys, but Godzilla versus Kong or something. So another one of those new monster universe movies, but because we have them all, of course, you know, we got to get the new one when it comes out, so I have all of them. But this one actually looks really cool. It's got Bryan Cranston in it, which I love him so much. But if you want to read about it here, guys, And this does have Dolby Atmos, so I'm pretty sure it's going to sound amazing. So, but yeah, there's Godzilla 2014. I like the subcover in this one. It's really nice. But yeah, when we went to Target, they had one copy left. So, oh, there's that. So happy you picked that up. Okay, next one up, guys. We had the Twilight Time film of this one, but I had no idea this movie is crazy expensive. Luckily, we have the Twilight Time edition, but so we ended up picking up this one, the Spain release, so we can watch it, and that is 9 to 5, guys. Awesome.
Well, wait a second. What you forgot to even mention is I didn't even know that was available.
Oh, yeah.
Because you're right. The Twilight Time movie is cool. I think I only found like two.
Yeah.
And one of them I think is the same because there's one on there's one on Amazon.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute, that's not the same one, baby. I'm thinking about something else completely different. But anyway, that right there wasn't even available. I wasn't even aware that was available and until I was about a week?
Yeah.
I think it was about a week when I happened to come across it. I wasn't even aware there was another release because it's never been released here in the United States except for the Twilight Time movies. Like you said, it's a very, very high dollar movie. And it kind of falls in that category of collectible. We already discussed that many times. Some of those pieces are very, very collectible. But anyway, that right there was, I think, I want to say with tax, there wasn't shipping.
Yeah.
Because once again, I think I didn't have to pay Prime for that.
I don't think so.
But it was under $30.
Yeah.
So basically, and I know a lot of people are interested in being able to have that. Not so much being able to see it.
Right.
But maybe just have it in their collection.
Exactly.
So, but you can't, you know, like I said, you can't beat $30 for that. Yeah.
Versus, you know.
And it's a very, very good movie.
Yeah. From 80? Yeah.
Yeah, it's like early 80s.
And I like, because this is almost the same cover as The Twilight Time, so it's not that much different, but I really, really want to watch it. I've never seen this movie before, but I love Dolly Parton, so, and, Lily Tomlin, so.
Another thing, when you have cable, I'm not talking about streaming, but if you have cable, it's a movie you basically don't even see. I haven't seen that movie probably in, well, it's probably been a couple of decades.
Right. You know, so. Like I said, I love Dolly Parton, Lily Tomlin. I'm not a big fan of Jane Fonda, but I still want to watch it, so. It also has
Dabney
Coleman in there as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but awesome, guys. Really want to sit down and watch it one night. I might just take it off the shelf and just watch it one night. So, but anyway, so the final movie before we get to the Amazon deal, guys. This came out yesterday or Tuesday. I'm sorry, today's Thursday, but
today's what?
Today's Thursday, isn't it?
Wednesday.
Oh, it is Wednesday, isn't it?
Yeah, baby, you're doing what I normally do. But I think we flipped.
It is Wednesday. I forgot. Yesterday was Tuesday. Anyway. Anyway, so I pretty much convinced them to buy this one. Like I said, I said in my shopping video. If you haven't seen my shopping video yesterday, I'll link it down below, guys. But I kind of convinced him to buy this one because he has the first one, the 4K Steelbook, from the first Wonder Woman. So I was like, you've got to get this one. And that is Wonder Woman 1984, the 4K Best Buy exclusive Steelbook. But now he has both. That's awesome. I really, really want to see this one. I heard this one wasn't not nearly as good as the first one, but still have to check it out because I love the first one. One of my favorite DC films, but I'm trying to get him to watch it with me. So
let me see the front. Oh,
I love the cover of this one. So
yeah,
much.
I just bought that. Like I said, I think I said that in your previous video because you had requested.
I did.
Basically saying because I had the first one that I needed to get that to go with it. So.
And guys, when we went to Best Buy yesterday, because I don't know what Best Buy's doing. They've been opening at 11 o'clock, so we got there and they're already open. They open at 10 o'clock now, I guess because of the Masters are here next week or something. I'm not sure. They're opening up earlier and back to 10 o'clock again. But they had so many of these Steelbooks, guys. It was ridiculous how many they had. So they had them in the new release section and the other section, like two spots. So if you missed out, they got plenty of them if you want one. So I really like the design of this one, guys. Yes, I really am really looking forward to checking this one out, guys. Okay. All right, so before we get to my movies, we'll talk about the Amazon deal first. I'm pretty good to go ahead and talk about it. All right, so if you have seen my other Amazon video, I'll link it down below, guys, if you haven't seen it. This is the same exact movie. So got it in the mail yesterday, and
wait, you just left a lot out. Let me just say this. Let me just set it up real quick. That last video you made, the video you made showing the damage
mm-hmm.
to that. to that four pack, I decided, because I didn't know what I was going to do, so I decided to call Amazon. I think it was Saturday or Sunday of last weekend, right?
Right.
Talked to a representative, and the representative said that he was sorry for what I went through, and they would send me another one.
Right.
And I would get that by Tuesday of this week. But I had to return the one that was damaged, which mm-hmm. I thought was kind of weird.
Right.
Because I explained to the representative, I said, it's in pieces.
Right.
So he said, that's fine. So anyway, we put it in an envelope. And I was told that it was when the replacement was to be sent, which was Tuesday.
Right.
That UPS would pick up the damaged one. Well, they happened to come a day early.
Right.
So anyway, so we got it Tuesday. Mm-hmm. That's the new one. And so you can show them what we got. And we already noticed or suspected, because it wasn't as badly damaged as the other one, but we did notice a little damage at the bottom.
Same spot.
But I was the one that decided, I said, can we go on and open it? So you open it and show them what we got.
Okay, well, it's not as bad as the last one, but it's still pretty bad, you guys. At least the plastic isn't all cut up, but the bottom didn't fall out like the last one, but it's still pretty smashed up. I mean, we've already opened it. So here's the bottom. This is cut right here. You can see where it's broken right here, guys, but I'm going to open it up because this side right here, it's snapped off. You can't even close it.
Right. And let me just, in case somebody doesn't believe this, this is right here is what they call
it. Is our address
return.
On there?
I don't think our address is on there, is it? Mm. I don't think it is. I didn't see it. That's just a return.
A return label.
A return label for it from the other one.
Right.
So like said earlier, that is the replacement.
All right.
The second one.
Open it up, guys. Okay, so the trays in here are just broken once again. This is broken again right here.
And something to mention, too, it's almost identical to the other one. It's almost identical. Now, I don't know how much we'd have to go back and look at the other video to make a comparison.
Well,
but
that's broken. That's gone. The thing that holds the tray in, that's broken. That's gone. This one's still here, but this one's gone, guys. But
something to point out real quick, when you close it.
You can't. It's broken.
No, where's it at? Where was the damage at?
Oh, yeah.
If you notice right down here, I think this is where the other one was damaged.
Same place.
It's the bottom right corner,
right.
Which is right there. And it tells me that what's happened is something apparently could have easily heavy. They could have had a maybe stack like this. And something came down, you know, came down to the top and hit it and damaged them.
Split all in there as well. So he ended up ordering some of these cases right here. So hopefully they're going to be okay. We can replace it and just throw this one away and keep the cover art, of course, and just throw this crap away. So
And don't bend that. That card. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to call Amazon again. And this time they're not going to get that one back because I'm past that. You know, it's like I said,
crazy,
it's, I don't know what I paid. I paid $22 or something like that for it. But I don't want to have to go through that again. So I'm still going to call Amazon and explain to them what happened and see what they say.
Yes.
Because they need to make sure that before, if it comes to where they'll send me another replacement, mm-hmm. they need to be absolutely sure that somebody in the warehouse actually looks.
Checks it.
Because apparently there's an issue with them, that they're them being damaged.
Right.
I know when you go on Amazon's site and you type that one in,
mm-hmm.
I think they have like 11,
right.
And there's more on the
coming,
way.
Yeah.
So, but it seems to me like that would be something fairly obvious, you know, because the other one was, I want to say, wasn't the other one ripped?
But the plastic was ripped.
But the plastic on the outside, was
it
ripped
up.
As well?
It's all cut up.
Okay.
Which I don't want to say how that happened, but it still had the tape on it. But we're taking that off. So.
And by the way, I could have easily not opened it. That was not Kimberly's decision. That was mine because I just wanted to see for myself, is it damaged like the other one? And sure enough, it is. So.
But anyway, guys, so these are all his pickups for the last week or so.
So like I said, I'll call Amazon.
Yep. So those are all his amazing movies, guys.
And by the way, something to mention real quick.
Yeah.
We've never been through.
Nope.
I've been collecting.
Not back to back.
Wait a minute. I've been collecting.
Sad.
Or I should say purchasing from Amazon.
Right.
Movies, that is, probably since about 2015.
Exactly.
And I think this is the first time. Now, I've had stuff that's been damaged before, you know, that I've had to return. We had a steel, wasn't it? We have a steel, but wasn't that Brad steel
book? Yeah, it was kind of
purchased from Amazon. It was dented, it was damaged. Yep. So, but you know, in all the years, I've had, you know, I've been fair. I guess I've been lucky because I've never really had to go through anything like this, especially something where I've gotten a replacement and the replacement is damaged as well.
Yeah, that's especially back to back, like you said.
Anyway, so like you said, I ordered what is it called, a 12 mil blue
with a flip trays in it,
and just you know, I can take it out and I could be done with it. And yeah, I guess the question would be, real quick, not to go on with this, is what would somebody else do?
Right.
You know, what would they do in a situation like this? Would they go for a third?
Yeah, I wouldn't do it. There's no way.
You said you wouldn't do it?
I wouldn't do it. There's no way. Okay.
Well, real quick, what I said to you this morning, I'm still going to call.
Oh, yeah, I know.
But I think what they should do, since I'm going to keep it, is they should give me credit. Give me a $22 whatever I paid for, to give me the credit because of what I went through.
Or credit the cases you had to buy.
Well, I don't know if they'll do that.
I don't know if they'll do that, yeah.
No, they just give me the credit for the movie. I'd be fine with that because I don't want to have to go. The only way I'll go through a third is they have to assure me that what they send me is not damaged.
Right, exactly. So, but you never know.
No, you don't.
But anyway, so I just want to show you what I got, guys. I got some movies right here to show you over the past week or so.
That was long.
Okay, so first one up, I've been wanting to see this for a long time. I've heard it's really, really good. It's from the producers of Get Out and Us, which I've already watched Get Out. It was okay. I need to get Us. I just thought Get Out was just a little overrated, in my opinion, a little overhyped. But I finally picked up Antebellum on 4K from Best Buy a couple weeks ago. And went back to Best Buy yesterday. Didn't have any 4Ks. Had Blu-rays on 4Ks. So really nice stuff on this one. Cannot wait to see Us. I need to get it to have all three of them. So, but yeah, there's Antebellum.
That's what I was going to ask you. How many of those have been made?
That I need to get Us. I'll have them all. So, Get Out was just kind of weird for me. Heard really good things about it. I watched it. I got it at, he bought from a month ago from Best Buy for like $3.99. It was just okay. It was just average, in my opinion. It wasn't really that scary. It was just kind of weird in some parts. But anyway, next up, guys. He actually got me this the other day. He was so sweet. Along with him when he got the Godzilla one. But that is Promising Young Women, guys. With Carrie Mulligan. I really, really want to see this one. I have really, really good things about this film. So, had to get my hands on this one. But really, really nice slipcover. It says, a game-changing masterpiece, guys. So, yeah, I like the pink on the top there. But, yeah, I've heard really, really good things. Got a lot of Golden Globe nominations. So, definitely want to check that out. All right, so the newest installment in the Disney Pixar 4K line, and that is the new Soul. With a really nice, look at that ball slipcover, guys. Just kills it with the slipcover. So, my dad and I watched this on the day it came out that night, and really, really enjoyed this film. I like the meaning behind it, but see. Yeah, Tina Fey, of course, you know, Jamie Foxx is the lead role in here.
Yeah, it's a great message, because basically what it's saying is live every day like the last. It's basically what it is.
Really beautiful message at the end, guys. But, I can see myself watching this again. This is Disney, one of Disney's best Pixars, or one of the best movies they've done. So, this is definitely my top 10. I wouldn't say my top 5, because I have a lot of other ones that are over this one, but definitely my top 10. I just love this one. So, I cannot wait for Raya and the Next Dragon, Last Dragon, that's coming out, I think, in May, I think, to 4K, so definitely want to check that one. I have really good things about that film, so yeah, that's the new Disney movie that's coming to 4K. I'm so excited to check that out. Okay, these are all from yesterday, guys. So, I've been at Best Buy so many times, and because this came out a couple months ago, I'm always going to Best Buy, no slipcover on. I'm like, okay, it really irritates me. So we went to Walmart yesterday, and I found it with a slipcover, and that's freaky, guys. Vince Vaughn and Catherine Newton, with a really nice embossed slip on this one. From the producers of Blumhouse, they did Happy Death Day, which I need to get those films. Happy Death Day and Happy Death Day, you heard they're really good. So, but I really want to check it out, guys. It actually looks really cool. But yeah, it's freaky. I'm trying to convince him to watch it with me. So, this is called the Killer Switch Edition. So, yeah, really nice embossed slip on that, guys. Awesome. All right, final two movies, guys. This one came in from Amazon because Best Buy, of course, didn't have us in their store. A lot of people were complaining they couldn't find this movie, but people were found it at like Target and Walmart. But he ended up pre-ordering this months ago, and that's The Ten Commandments. One of my all-time favorite movies right here. I love Charlton Heston, one of my favorite actors, but this is what we watch every Easter, guys. It's absolutely love. I cannot wait to watch it in 4K. This is my first time owning it, because he has it like three times. Two times.
I have it twice.
Yeah.
I have the Digibook. Wow. And then I also have that double set with Ben-Hur. Yes.
That's crazy.
The double feature, which is really, really hard to find.
Yeah. But when that Digibook came out, I was
No, I'm sorry. That's wrong. It's not hard to find. It's just expensive.
Right.
Yeah. Good correction.
But when that Digibook came out, he ended up getting one. I don't know why I never got one. And now I can't find him anywhere. So,
Did you check? Did you check on Amazon?
I haven't checked on Amazon.
I want to say you can still buy those.
But I love Charlton Heston here. Of course, he plays Moses in this film. But I got Edward G. Robinson, Yul Brynner, Yvonne DiCarlo in here. But one of my favorite movies of all time. It's a long film, but it's so, so good. It doesn't feel like a three-hour movie. Just goes by so fast, guys. All right, next one up. Of course, the new release of the week, and that's Wonder Woman 1984. Ended up getting the 4K edition of this one. I need to get the first one in 4K. I have it on Blu-ray. I have the Digibook that Target usually puts out, but I don't know if they made one for this one. I'm not sure if they made a 4K subcover or a Digibook for this one. I know they had a different subcover for this one. That subcover is so cool, guys. But I like the subcover on this one as well. That's really nice. Rainbow effect there, but yeah, I really want to check it out, guys. It looks really cool. But yeah, there's Wonder Woman 1984. Of course, it has Chris Pine is back in this one again, and of course, Ava Gadot is Wonder Woman. So that's why it's Kristen Wiig in here too. That's pretty awesome. So yeah, I love Kristen Wiig. So all right, these are my pickups, guys.
Yeah, and
sweet.
And something to mention too is
what
I got that. I think I should be getting in the next few days. There's actually two of them coming in. One of them is the American Werewolf in London Zombie Steelbook. Did I order two of those?
You got one from Amazon and one from, we got you one from Zombie. Then you end up getting, so we can watch it, I guess, or open
so
it.
So I do have two of them?
Yeah, you got two coming, so.
Okay. And also, I got the movie Fist.
Oh, yeah.
That's
so cool.
That's coming from UK.
From Denmark.
Oh, it's coming from Denmark.
I thought
it was the UK.
Nope, those are the Denmark symbols on the side. So,
oh, okay.
Like that, what's that, okay. Oh, the hard way? It's got those numbers on the bottom. That's from Denmark. So that should be here soon, guys. We have two, so cool. First time ordering from, what's it called? iMusic from Denmark or something?
It's I called, think it's ID.
ID Music. It's so it's cool. Called. They have some really cool stuff on
music,
there.
Yeah.
And yeah, that is pretty
is
much it, guys.
Else?
So nothing
is
I can think
else?
Of. That's coming out for a while,
sure.
So I think whenever I'm trying to think, Raya and the Last Dragon comes out, I might make a shopping video for that. But that one actually looks really cool. It's on Disney Plus, which I don't have Disney Plus. So, but anyway, guys, that is all I picked out for last week or so. So make sure to like this video, guys. Comment down below. Stop you. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Let me know if you think of our pickups. What have you picked up recently? Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Share this video around, guys. I guess I will talk to you later. Bye.